welkom sul mio canale in this beautiful Belgian weather. Yes, I had some questions about the tune and introduction. Well, it's a double shuffle. So that's the topic of the day. Double shuffle. It's a bowing technique. The tune comes from, it's a part of the Orange Blossom special. It's a bluegrass classic. If you want to learn that, I show you the book where I learned it from. A fantastic book. It shows so many tricks and legs of a bluegrass fiddle. And the last chapter, it's all about the Orange Blossom special. The tune that will bring you a lot of money and success. Voilà. So good luck with it. Double shuffle. It's a trick, a bowing trick, that is even sometimes forbidden in some fiddle championships. But it's nice. Comes also a little bit, they used it in American folk, but also in Celtic music now and then. It's a bit in ragtime atmosphere. So it's a bit like this. It's like, you will see it here, it's like a pattern of three and a bar of four. Voila. Just like the offbeat shuffle. But you change it. It's a really nice trick, and once you can play it, it's very easy. You can use it all the time, first in tunes and some improvisations. How to start? You can just learn from score. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. The problem is, because the bow changes always the direction. So it's like down bow, down bow, but then it's a bow, down, up. And of course, you have to stop after a while. So it's a pattern of two bars. The best thing, I think, to play it is when you really feel the basic rhythm. The four, one, two, three, four. I see it a lot in sessions and people start playing the double shuffle. They start speeding up and it's not nice. It's a trick. And when you want to use that trick, use it well. Use it. If you don't use it well, it's stupid. If you do something like in color and you start speeding up, it's stupid. Voilà. So start using it well. And the best way to learn it is that you can put your feet in the bar of four. I will give you a metronome. It's nice when you feel this, the basic beat. See, and my feet goes, I can see it, my feet goes with the metronome. A very easy way to learn this, stop for a while, stop, thank you. To learn this, you can just clap your hands and sing the pattern. You can do it in the train, and you're waiting for the bus, or you're waiting for the doctor, or you're just going for a walk on the street, clap your hands and you go like. And a very easy way to sing it is a method I learned from Indians to study, to practice polyrhythms. And this one is a polyrhythm of three. So you can say like takiki. So takiki, ta is the accent and you have three. Two is taki taki, so you just do it like taki 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 taki, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, taki 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 ta. When you want to practice the obi, kiki taki kiki taki kiki taki kiki taki. It's very easy. Each note has a syllabus, and when you want the accent, you put a ta, and the others is just ki, and they're all regular. Kiki taki ki taki ki taki kaki. It's so. Now we do want to practice a double shuffle. So it goes like kiki ta kiki ta kiki ta. You have the pattern of three. I will write it here. So practice it. So it's like you start to feel the basic rhythm. Kiki ta kiki ta kiki ta kiki ta kiki ta. I will do it with the metronome, but it's maybe easier. So do kiki taki kiki taki kiki taki kiki taki kiki ta. And now you have to practice this three. You go kiki taki kiki taki kiki kiki taki kiki 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 kiki. So you don't think about keys and tas, just sing it regular so you get used to the thing. Once you get used to it, you give the tas a small accent. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kiki taki ki 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 taki. You feel sometimes the ties with the beat, sometimes not. It changes all the time. That's what it makes it so nice. And just practice it a lot. It's fantastic to get to feel the feel the double shuffle. Not only to see it on the score and play it, but to feel it. Then you can use it very easily also in your improvisations. And then you slowly speed it up. You go like 1, 2, 3, 4. Kiki taki ki 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 taki. And then it's getting difficult. You make the halftime beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kiki taki ki taki ki taki ki taki ki taki ki ki ta. You go faster. Kiki taki ki taki ki taki ki taki ki taki. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kiki taki ki 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 taki. You feel it's nice when you're just feeling it. You just practice it when you have nothing else to do, and then you start playing. 1, 2, 3, 4. See it, but my feet is going together with the metronome. In folk music, you're allowed to use your feet and to make noises, not in classical music, of course. And voila, you start feeling it. It's a very good exercise. You can also practice other patterns like 5 and 7. It's a very good exercise to practice 5/4 or 7/4, the system of taki, taki, taki. So you just say for one syllabus, one note, for one note, one syllabus. So you say ta u ki. When you do, for example, 5, you do ta ki ki ta ki, which is 5. Or 7, ta ki ki ta ki ta ki. So let's try the exercises. First 5. Ta ki ta ki ta ki ta ki. We try 1, 2, 3, 4. Ta ki ki ta ki 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 ta ki ki ta ki. And so on, and have fun with it. 7, the same, we do ta ki ki ta ki ta ki. Ta ki ta ki ta ki ta ki ta ki ta ki ta ki. 1, 2, 3, 4. Taki ki taki 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 ki taki taki. And so you can do a lot of tricks and polyrhythms in your solos. Like for example 7. 1, 2, 7. 1, 2, 3, and. And feel free to do more interesting patterns. An easy reel from Canada, Quebec, on the Mount of the Tobique. It's a very popular session tune. The problem is there's so many versions. I will do like what I think the version I heard. A lot, but you will see I mix them up too. It's 3 parts, and the 3rd part has this double shuffle part. I will start with this. So you do like this. It's this thing, but you change the notes like. So you do 3, they go to the B and the C. And try to also learn this with the metronome. One, two, three, and. Voilà. And then you just slow, speed this up. 1, 2, 3. Voilà. And if it's not yet clear, so the G stays on the D string and you change from the B on the A string to the C all the time. And you do like double stops. But it's nice, it gives automatically a small accent. And the other notes, they're a bit like ghost notes. So then there's like the answer. There are many versions, this is the one I have in my head. You will see the score later, but try to learn it like this. Try. And let's go up from the G. And let's learn the last note. Voilà. We can play it in a shuffle feel. It's not in a swing feel, but in America they do more like a shuffle feel. So you slur two notes. Two slur. Separate. Voilà. So this is the second answer is like this. Part. I will play it for you. I will do it again with the metronome, so you understand the rhythm well. 2, 3. It's clear. I forgot there is like this. The thing before you start the melody, two notes before the bars. And the rest is learning the bowing. You can choose. You can also do it more in the swing feel. You understand the difference? I do it more. More the Irish way to play it. I think I learned in the Canadian way, they do it more straight and more in a shuffle feel. It's the way what you choose, what style you want to play that melody. Voilà, now we have the first part, it's very similar, it's easy. It's all in G minor, it's all constructed about the G major chord and the D major 7. So I play it once for you. In a shuffle way now. So it's quite easy. So I do it slowly. The first bar. Use the fourth finger. Open string always not so good. It's all G major chords. And then we have this typical folk track, we do the melody is this. But your G stays on the D string and you double stop. But very softly. And you get this really nice folk folk bowing about the D and the A string. It gives you that groove. Voila! So it's like. So, starts at the beginning. The same as the end, you remember? Just the scale of G. And just learn the last note. and you have oboe, and you're ready here to start again. It's the same melody. And then the ending, many ways of more in a Celtic way, because that's where it's coming from, or with this ornament, you remember? Bowing and ornaments, I explained them in the other videos very slowly. So you can always go to the other videos and practice the bowing and the ornaments, and then you go back and you have no difficulties anymore to understand them. And that's the first part. Let me go it again with the metronome. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, and 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, Where sometimes people go to a minor chord. Some just in G major. It's nice to go to the E minor. Recognize that part. So it's not that difficult. So the beginning is. Yeah, a lot of turns. Learn this. A D major chord. And here many versions. I used to play this. But I think the real version is this. But there are even other versions. The same. So, are wrong. And it's the same ending. I go a bit fast, but it's always the same. So I do it once more, slow with the metronome, so I can understand the rhythm well. One, two, voilà. And there is just one part, I think maybe it's not clear. And the second part. Voilà! It's a good tune to practice your double shuffle. And practice it, and learn the Orange Blossom Special, and earn a lot of money. You can use this kind of silly tricks, but remember, in some fiddle competitions, it is not allowed to use double shuffles. Good luck, and see you next time.